ESMO 18 has been a great conference for breast cancer. We had several important news and one presidential session dedicated only to breast cancer. And I will give some highlights on some important research, both in the early setting first and then move to the metastatic setting. I think that there are two major topics to be discussed for the early setting. One is the topic of adjuvant endocrine therapy in premenopausal women with hormone receptor positive breast cancer. We had the presentation for the first time of the results of the OBOE trial, a randomized trial including more than 1,000 premenopausal women that were randomized to receive ovarian function suppression plus tamoxifen or letrozole, or the combination letrozole and zoledronic acid. And the study concluded that letrozole, so an aromatase inhibitor, appear to be superior to tamoxifen, even though not statistically significant. But the most interesting finding was that the addition of zoledronic acid on the top of letrozole significantly proved disease-free survival with an 8% benefit at 5 years in disease-free survival. And on the same topic, the French investigators presented the first results of the CANTO study. This is a prospective study that wanted to assess, after 1 year of tamoxifen therapy in premenopausal women, how many of them were actually taking the medication. And this is very important because we know that treatment adherence in young women is lower because of several reasons, including fertility and pregnancy-related issues. But this is the first time that we had this information objectively collected in the blood of the patient with the measurement of the tamoxifen level in the blood. And what the investigator observed is that up to more than 15% of young women with breast cancer actually do not take adjuvant endocrine therapy as they would be supposed to do. And the risk of being non-adherent is higher for women that do not receive prior chemotherapy. And then in the early setting, I think the other important news is related to the use of shorter trastuzumab duration, so 6 months. Six months or even less as compared to the standard 1 year duration. Here we had the presentation of two important sub-analyses of the shorter trial recently published in Annals of Oncology. And here the shorter investigators presented a TIL, tumor infiltrating lymphocyte analysis, and the subgroup analysis looking at the efficacy of the two trastuzumab duration according to baseline patient characteristics. And the main take-home message from these two presentations is that having high TILs is associated with a better prognosis, and also these women may benefit of a shorter duration of adjuvant trastuzumab, as well as patients that have a small tumor, less than 2 centimeters, and non-negative tumor. So conclusion in the same line as the meta-analysis recently published in Breast Cancer Research and Treatment by Bishop, Givali and colleagues, showing the same, that 1 year overall is the best option, but for patients at low risk of disease recurrence, a shorter duration may be considered. Moving to the metastatic setting, this is where we got the most important news for breast cancer patients. We had 4 important presentations during the first plenary session. The presentation that everybody was waiting for is the inpatient trial, the first phase 3 trial with the use of immunotherapy in triple negative breast cancer. In this trial, 900 triple negative breast cancer patients were randomized to first line nab-paclitaxel alone versus nab-paclitaxel plus PD-L1 inhibitor atezolizumab. And the trial showed that although the PFS result was significantly positive towards the atezolizumab arm, this was not really very exciting data. It was less than 2 months PFS benefit in the overall population, slightly more than 2 months in the PD-L1 positive population. But the most interesting findings is the fact that the overall survival of PD-L1 positive patients with the use of immunotherapy improved of over 10 months. That is something that we have probably never seen in the field of triple negative breast cancer. And the last 3 presentations of the presidential are on the same topic: the use of endocrine therapy plus targeted therapy in patients with endocrine resistant advanced breast cancer. The first study is the PALOMA 3, fulvestrant palbociclib versus fulvestrant. Here the investigators presented the overall survival data showing a 7 months absolute improvement in overall survival, not statistically significant, but I think clinically very relevant. The second trial is the SOLAR-1 that investigated alpelisib plus fulvestrant versus fulvestrant alone in PIK3CA mutated or PIK3CA not mutated patient. And the take-home message is that these drugs works very well only for the PIK3CA mutated cohorts, with the almost more than 5 months absolute improvement in progression-free survival in this specific patient population. And finally, the results of a Chinese study on the use of histone deacetylase inhibitor, kinamide, in association with exemestane versus exemestane alone. Again, interesting findings, almost 4 months absolute improvement in progression-free survival, but I think that a trial that should be also performed and confirmed in the Western population. Yes, CDK4/6 inhibitor plus endocrine therapy has now become a standard treatment approach for patients with luminal advanced breast cancer. We had in the last year several important studies in both the endocrine sensitive setting as well as in the endocrine resistant setting, and in both settings the use of the addition of these agents to endocrine therapy is associated with significant improvement in progression free survival, and now we start to have some data also on the benefit in overall survival. At here at ESMO we also had the presentation of quality of life data, so patient reported outcomes data from this trial, showing that even though of course adding a targeted agent increases the incidence of side effects, still this is not associated with the worse quality of life and the worse performance at the patient reported outcomes analysis. So these are very important treatment options that we should now adopt in daily clinical practice.